We'll discuss how to create a variables we have discussed, and today we'll see how to use conditional statements in Java. Okay, Java project. Here's some project name. Yeah, just a second, I'm getting some issue. I'm really not sure. I'm getting an error. Java project. Build path. Configure build path. I'm going to configure that. Just a minute, to configure Java Standard Edition 1.8. Okay, dedicate. See, why you are getting this error? Because the Eclipse which I have installed is the latest one which I have installed. It is not compatible with the JRE. That's why I'm installing JRE once again. So this is Java Standard Edition 8, okay. JDK 1.8.0_291. That's what it is. Let me see. closing Eclipse anyway. So meanwhile, we'll discuss if you have any questions, Sabir. You have any questions? Oh my God, I sent some different person.
Hello,
Shabir, do you have any questions?
This Shabir here, who is this?
Shabir, do you have any questions? I'm asking, do you have any questions?
Presently, I don't have, sir.
Yeah. Fine. What I'm saying, we have some JR issue. We are restarting the system. I mean, I will try to open without restarting the laptop. If required, I may restart. I will join again. Okay. Oh my God.
Sir, just ping. Hello, sir. Sir, just ping me. I will be back.
So power cut is there, I think, for Raja Sen. He has some power cut issue. That's why it's not done. Okay.
I will be online, sir. Just ping me, okay, sir?
Sure. Fine. Yeah, gone. Error is gone now. Look at here. All errors are gone. Right? Hello? Shabir?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Shabir. Yeah. Yeah, we are able to resolve the issue. What is the issue? The issue is very simple. The JRE which we have installed is not compatible. Okay. That's why I have installed the latest JRE 1.8. Okay, 1.8 only the MOS supports, Eclipse MOS. But you won't have these issues on your system because the one which I have shared is the latest one. You don't need to do any troubleshooting. Okay, let's see. Okay. See, I told you, Java has three sections. First one is a package. What is package? What is package? Package is nothing but a collection of related classes. Okay, that means multiple classes can be organized using packages. Okay, coming to the next section where we will import all the required jar files. Required Java files will be imported in our import section, java.util. Okay. Sure. Okay, this is how we will import. Import required packages here. Then we'll have a class name. This is our class name and this is a main method. What is the purpose of main method? Main method acts as a entry point. Now we'll write a very simple program, system.out.println. Now, okay, this is a very simple program. Just right click, run as Java program. This is how we will run our Java program. See, coming to the conditional statements today, last class we have discussed about the various data types like integer, a comma b, okay, a comma b, float, okay, c. Okay, load C. Now coming to, I'm going to write a very simple function, very simple method. How to write a method? We can write a method very, very simple manner. First to allow to the method and the general ga. First we have access specifier, public, private, protected. These are access specifiers in Java. Okay. Access specifiers in Java. I will explain what is this access specifiers later, but by default we will use public and the return type. Okay. And the method name. Okay. And parenthesis and the spiral brackets starting and ending. Inside this, we have a block of code. Here, see, I want to create a calculator application. How to create? You tell me. I want to create a calculator application. So, what are the basic operations you can perform using calculator? Quickly.
Sorry, sir.
What are the basic operations you can perform using calculator?
Subtraction, addition.
Correct. So I'll write a very simple class of calculator. Class name is calculator. Okay. Okay. Finish. Okay. So this is a public class. Name of the calculator is this one. The class name is this. Then we are going to create integer value 1, value 2, okay, float value 3. Okay. So we have created two variables, value 1 equals to 0, value 2 equals to 0, and value 3 equals to 0. You have defined all the values. That's fine. Absolutely fine. So currently we have three variables, variable 1, variable 2, and variable 3. Now coming to methods, how to create a method? As I said, we have access specifier and the return type name of the method. Access specifier is public. Okay, return type is integer. Method name is addition. One method is over. Okay. What is the issue? And return. Yeah, return. Correct. Return. Okay. Value. Return. Return temp. Right. Okay. So still we got an error. Initialize variable. Okay, next one more method, public float. Okay, float division. Division. Okay, float temp equals 0, return temp. Done. Okay, one more public int. Okay, multiplication.
Just a wait, sir. Hello. Bolo.
Okay.
Hello.
Sir. Yes, yes. Tell me. Hello, Shabir, tell me.
Sorry, sir. Continue.
That's it. Okay. So we have created a. What is this?
Additional add division.
Oh, it is okay. Multiply, it is int actually. Fine. No problem. See, this is how we have to declare a function. See, look at here.
So in public, in second line, you have. In first is public integration, then second is public float. Why it is public float?
Yeah, I told you, right? I will explain later these access modifiers, but look at how to create functions.
And functions. Okay.
Access modifiers is a very big concept. We can't finish talk now. Okay. See, public means same way. Public and unte avutundante ee methods ee class lo nunchi byte kuda access chesukochu ani.
Okay, sir.
పబ్లిక్ అంటే ఏంటంటే ఈ మెథడ్స్ అన్ని కూడా ఈ క్లాస్ బయట కూడా యాక్సెస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ పబ్లిక్. ఓకే, ప్రైవేట్ అంటే వీ కాంట్ యాక్సెస్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ద క్లాస్, వీ కెన్ యాక్సెస్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ సైడ్ ద క్లాస్. ఓకే, హోప్ యూ ఆర్ క్లియర్. నౌ ఇంటీజర్ 1 ఈక్వల్ టు 0. నౌ వీల్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్ ఎ లాజిక్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద లాజిక్ యాక్చువల్లీ? ఎడిషన్, రైట్? టెంప్ ఈక్వల్ టు, ఓకే, టూ పారామీటర్స్ వీఆర్ పాసింగ్ హియర్, ఇంటీజర్ A, integer B.
B.
A plus B. Okay. So value. Okay, now the second one. Now, what is the next one? Division. Division, how we are going to divide actually? Again, okay, value 3 equals to A divided by B. That's it. So here again, integer A. Integer B. Done. Okay. And then again, this is not required. Again, here multiplication, we need two numbers, integer A, integer B. Inside this, again, value 2 equals to A multiplication with B. That's it. This is 2. Right. Okay. And finally, here also subtract. Okay. Again, we need two numbers, integer A, integer B. Okay. Okay. Now, inside this, again, value 1 equals to, value 1 equals to A minus B. That's it. Okay. So now, how many functions we have written? Look at here. To understand you better, you can always check in a package explorer. How many variables are there? Variable 1, variable 2, variable 3. Two variables are there. And four functions are there. These are nothing but functions. Red color dots are functions. Addition, division, multiplication, and subtraction. Division. Okay. Multiplication and subtraction. Okay. Now, how to call these functions? These functions are only use object or create child. Okay, class ni mana vary class lo kuda access kada idi mana class. Okay, I'm going to create an object equals to new. Now, what we are going to do? I'm just going to write a very simple function. Very simple function. Okay, if I'm going to define a simple character here. Okay, character, okay, operation. Now, if operation equals to addition, A, okay, A, okay. If operation equals to A, operation only, right? Control C, B. So initialize variable, that's fine. Yeah. If operation equals to A, then I want to execute addition program. Okay. How to execute addition program? Okay. We have already created here. Similarly, else if operation equals to D, if operation equals to D, it will execute division operation. I'll see. Okay. If operation equals to D, it will execute division operation. Else if, okay. So, alagane manaki operation equals to M. M ganiki isthe manam multiplication ante multiply cheyali. So, alagane manaki control C, control V. Okay. Division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. Finally.
Okay.
And last, okay, else. This is not required. Else. Delete it. Okay. That's it. Very simple. This is a okay basic conditional statements. Conditional statement. Ante. Okay. So my thinking actually my key scanner operate scanner function out. Scanner function. Okay. How to use scanner function? Ante when a program executes manaki, it's supposed to ask which type of operation we are going to perform. I'll write a very simple function of a scanner class. I think it should be util only. No need to, okay, import anything. Okay, here. Before going to, okay, create, here we'll create a simple function, very simple function, scanner, my OBJ equals to new scanner of, okay, system.in. Okay. So we are creating a scanner object to read the data. To read the data, we are just creating a very simple function. After that, after scanning the object, what we have to do? We have to use a system dot out dot println of enter the operation name. Okay. So this is a new line. That okay. Whatever. Okay. Continue. Okay. So now system dot out dot println of okay a per addition. Okay. And then a new line. And then control C, control V, control V, control V, right. A for addition, B for, not B actually. Yeah. D for division. M for multiplication. Okay, and finally, S for subtraction. S for subtraction. That's it. Okay. So now, what we have to do? We are just capturing the data from new scanner, and then after that, what we have to do? We have to capture a read. I mean, a data from the online. Okay. So I'm going to write string. String. Username, otherwise operation. Okay. Operation equals to my obj dot next line of. Okay. We are just reading a line. Read a line, okay, from inputs. Okay, so we just captured a new line. What happened? Next line. Sorry, it's actually capital new line, right? So now we have captured operation equals to, we have just resigned, and then if it is A, it will execute this one, otherwise next it will go to the next line. Let me finish the program and then I will explain what we are basically doing. Okay. Yeah, this is the object which we have created. I'm just going to take this object, control C, control V dot, control V dot addition, addition. Okay. So here I'm just passing a 5, 6. First operation is over. Next division. Division. Okay. What is the division value? Sum 18 and then 3. Right. This is also over. Okay. Next multiplication. Multiply. Okay. 4. And then 5. Okay. Next, subtraction. Finally, subtraction, subtract of 10, 5. Right. Okay. So, division. So, what happened? Division, what's the wrong? Yeah, fine. Okay. So, after you had to capture the values, right? Because they are returning some values. Hence, what is the return type? See, look at here. Addition, it returns integer. And integer ni manaki return chestundi. Function poorthi ayin tarvata. So mana oka integer value isukuni dantlo assign chestunna. Integer results equals to. Okay. Then simply use system dot out dot print ln of the value of the value of addition is okay plus result. Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V. Okay. Invalid selection. Valid selection. Right. Done. So the results, again, you have to create some temporary variable. Control C. Control V. 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 Right. Or it should be float, basically. Float. Right. Done. So try to understand this program. Try to understand this program. See, very simple. This is a main method. This method actually basically execute the classes of methods that are defined in another class. We have two classes here. This is a calculator class. Calculator class has how many methods? Addition, division, multiplication, and subtraction. All these methods finally return some value. Okay. And coming to our main method, this is a main method. To access these methods, we have to create an object. We are creating an object for this class. I will explain why we are creating these objects. What is this object and all? I will explain later. So we have created. And there is one more simple code, scanner. Scanner, basically, this class is used to accept the data from the console in the runtime. రన్టైమ్ లో ఏమవుతుందంటే మనం ఏదైనా డేటా ఇస్తే ఆ డేటాని బట్టి ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది. అంటే ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏ ఎంటర్ చేస్తాం అనుకోండి, ఎడిషన్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది. బి ఎంటర్ చేస్తే ఇది సారీ డి ఎంటర్ చేస్తే డివిజన్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది. అలాగే ఎం ఎంటర్ చేస్తే మల్టిప్లికేషన్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది. ఫైనల్ గా ఇఫ్ యూ గివ్స్ ఎస్ ఆటోమేటిక్ ఇట్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ సబ్స్ట్రాక్షన్. ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్? ఐ నో ఇట్ ఇస్ బిట్ డిఫికల్ట్. ఓకే, యాజ్ ఎ ఫ్రెషర్ టు జావా ఐ నో బిట్ డిఫికల్ట్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్, బట్ ట్రై టు అండర్స్టాండ్. We have created two classes. One is a calculator class. Inside a calculator class, we have defined four methods: addition, division, subtraction, multiplication. Here we are just adding, subtracting, multiplication, and division. See how to use these methods. We have to create an object for the class. So this is the class which we have created. After that, we are just fetching the data in runtime by using scanner class. After fetching the data, if you are going to enter A, it will execute addition. If you enter D, it will execute division. If you enter M, it will execute multiplication. If you enter S, it will execute a.
Okay. I understand that. Just I need one thing. Okay. That in the calculator demo and in class, first you have public int. Then why you have wrote public float? Why you wrote the float one? Public float. Like is the
public float, addition, okay. Floating point maniki division chesthe maniki integer values raavu kada, okka sari floating point values ostayi kada.
Okay, and dan kosam for division you have wrote dan kosam.
Except division, remaining all I put integer only.
Okay,
division chesthe maniki perfect numbers raavu kada.
Okay,
run as division. Now it's awesome. See, A is addition, B, D is division, M is multiplication, S is subtraction. Now enter. It is asking for input. And this is going to give a division or multiplication or subtraction. I'm going to give yes, subtraction. If you give yes, what happened? It's going to execute subtraction. So 10 minus 5, how much?
5.
Invalid selection. It gone entirely different method. I don't know. Let me check. Integer null. Okay. So why add cast to character? Operation 1, 2, 3, 4, all places are same. Okay. Equals to yes.
సార్ ఇది ప్లస్ రిజల్ట్ అని దాంట్లో
the value
of Adion is plus result.
The value of
Adion is plus positive result అంటే లేకపోతే అంటే దాంట్లో మనం సింబల్స్ రాయాలా లేకుండా
ఎక్కడ
ఇక్కడ మన ఇంటిగర్స్ కింద అంట అడిషన్ చేంజ్
Clear is going in valid selection only. So enter the operation name A, invalid selection while. Control C. Okay, string. This is not string, this is character. Change type of operations to string. Yes. Why? Okay. I think we did a small mistake here. I'm just checking anyway. The article is enclosed with the double quotes. Now it should work. Let's see. Control S, just right click. Run as Java application. Yes. Okay. I just want to do multiplication, value selection. M for division, division, addition, multiplication, subtraction. really not aware, but I'm trying with the multiple solutions. I'm trying CSC.
Okay, sir. Good.
My object dot. Okay, there is another method that is character. Okay, character dot. Dot next dot character. Yes. Okay, character zero. Plus this is character. Okay, again I have to change. Subtract. Okay. Okay. Run as Java application. Oh, there is an error. Translate X control is right click run as Java application and yes, perfect. Okay, so you need to explore various options. There are so many options are there in the scanner. One of the syntax is this is a syntax. Next dot character. Okay. So MOBJ is a scanner function. If you want to retrieve the entire line, we'll use the next line. But we are using only character only, right? That's why you have to change slightly. Okay. Read a character from input. Okay. Read a character from input. If the character is A, it will execute addition. Okay. Just right click and run once again. Run as Java application. Just click OK. So now I just want to enter A 11. See, look at here. Got it? Are you clear now? Just let me know if you have any questions. This is how we use the conditional statements. This is a conditional statement. If operation 1 equal to A and this one. But suppose I want to use either A or capital A. If okay, so copy the same thing. Control C. Okay, I want to enter okay, you have entered small character. R, right? This is R. Okay, R. Control C. Control V. Yeah. Okay. Control X. Control V. Control C, Control V, operation equals A. Enter, capital, capital. Now see, look at here. We are not doing any rocket science here. It's a very simple program. If condition, any if condition, we are using operator 1 equals to A. This symbol actually here, we are using a symbol called a pipe symbol. This indicates R, okay? And if you give AND, it indicates AND symbol. This indicates NOT symbol. This indicates NOT. Just remember this actually. These are actually logical operators. Logical operators. Okay? AND, R, and NOT. Here we are using two pipe symbol that indicates R. And capital letter and enter jayachu, let the small letter and enter jayachu. Small letter enter jayachu, E condition fulfill out undi. Capital letter enter jayachu, if condition kali, E block of code execute. Clear? So just right click. Run a Java page. Okay, again, now I'm going to try with the capital letter. A enter jayachu. You have entered capital letter and the value of addition is 11. So this is how we have to write a simple, very simple programs. Are you clear? Are you clear with the conditional statements? Yeah, yes, no, no, yes.
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay. That's fine. We stop here. Okay.
Okay.
Tomorrow, Monday we'll meet. Meet Monday and we'll discuss the remaining conditional statements. Yeah, I think.
Sorry, sir, not pumpy, sir.
Yeah.
Recording, I can also pumpy.
Sure, sure, sure. I'll share. Sure, sure. But see, recording, if you miss, you won't get actually focus in your class only. You are paying fees, not for recordings. Okay, you have to ask more questions in classes.
So okay. The question can be asked, but. I need to look how did you type that and how did
correct,
you
correct agreed. Please practice tomorrow and day after tomorrow.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Okay then.
Thank you, sir.
I'm going to stop sharing the screen. Yeah.
Yes, sir. That's thank fine. You. Sir.